Module 4, Correlogram Analysis. In this module, we will show how NumXL can provide correlogram analysis. For this module, I will use the same spider log returns as in Module 2. Let's begin with our analysis. Switch to the NumXL toolbar tab or menu, and click on the Correlogram Analysis icon. Select the cells range of the sample data in our workbook. You will also need to specify how your data has been chronologically ordered. Since our sample data is sorted so that the oldest entries are at the top, I can leave the ascending checkbox checked. Next, in the ACF section, check the ACF option, and edit the maximum lag order in our analysis. By default, the maximum lag is set to 10. Now, check the upper and lower limits option, as well as the graph option. Finally, enter a value for the significance level, or leave the default of 5%. Do the same for the PACF, partial autocorrelation factor. In the output section, both the table and the graph output range defaults to the current active cell. For our demo, we will leave them unchanged. Click OK to continue. Let's examine the output table and graph. In the output table, examine the ACF entry. The value is computed using the ACF function. The ACF function references the input sample data and the lag order of the table row index. Next, examine the ACF graph, upper and lower limits entries. The values are computed using ACF CI functions. The ACF CI function references the input sample data, row index of the table and the test significance level. This concludes Module 4. If you have any questions, concerns or feedback, please call our toll-free number at 1-888-427-9486. Or, email us at support@spiderfinancial.com. We look forward to working with you.